Hey. Can you please read the description, please? It's very, very important, and, yeah, just please read the description in the pinned comment. It's very, very important. Okay, and it'll explain some things in the video before people start complaining. So, I just want to show you something about how I choose my shadow colors. I go down on the color wheel, more towards cooler colors, and then also, you can see there, I make the color slightly less saturated, and... No, I bring it closer towards the saturation, but a little away from it, like I just make it darker. So go more towards the cool colors, and then just go down on that diamond wheel thing. If you find that the color is too dark, then you should just like edit your layer and make the opacity of your layer darker. If it's already a cool color, then there's no need to touch the color wheel and only need to touch the color diamond thing. Alright, anyway, this is my layer setup. I have the character, then I have the base color, and then I have the line art of the shirt. Since we're only shading this big, nice hoodie, because that's what the video is about. It's about shading. I'm not going to be getting into too much detail, but I made two new brushes, so... Yeah, I'll put the QR code at the end of the video if you guys want the brushes that I'm using. Alright? So, anyway, this recording is a little messed up because the video was actually deleted because I accidentally deleted it, but then I re-retrieved it. But then after retrieving it, the video was super, like, glitchy and slow at some parts but fast at other parts. So, okay. Get your normal airbrush and make the bottom of your shirt darker, and then I use a skin tone about the top of the neck and the wrist, just like a light tap. And this is all done on a multiply layer. The shading is always done on a multiply layer. Make triangle shapes when you shade, instead of using circles or whatever else you would shade. After I discovered about using triangles for my shading, I feel like it upgraded by 5, like, gazillion percent, if that's even a thing. If gazillion is a thing, but you know what I think is a thing. Anyway, so instead of focusing on small shadows, focus on your main shapes first. So just make a bunch of big triangles. And then at the bottom, you can blend the bottom of your shadow only, not the top. If you do the top, then your hoodie thingy, or whatever you're shading, will just look like crap. So... only blur the bottom of it, if you know what I mean. Alright, and now I'm going in, making the shadows even darker, to add a little more detail. You could leave it how it is now, but I'm someone that likes a little more detail. Anyway, this is, these are the values. Values isn't, like, the cost, it's the, like, frick. Okay, look, she's got bright values, she's got dark values. I figured that you can use some more dark values around. Making a layer above your entire drawing and setting it to color setting, and then just using gray, shows that it can just, like, help you see if your drawing has good values or what. Damn, my brain is dead. My brain's dead when stuff happens. Alright. Anyway, my phone's glitching again, like, a little... Alright, so I'm just using a big, like, soft brush and going around everything to try to... Okay, see? Now we got good values. Now we got, like, a lot of dark values, we have a wide range of values, and it makes our drawing look like it pops out more. So that's cool. Then, on a new layer that I set to screen, I then add some highlights. Highlights isn't exactly necessary, and it can actually make your drawing look a little shiny, if that's not what you want. But that's just what I do. Okay, also... edit your line art, don't just leave it like black or something. Edit your line art. That's what I'm doing now. I'm editing my line art. Yeah, as you can see, the retrieved footage is kind of messed up, but I couldn't really afford to redo the entire thing, because if I redid the entire thing, by afford I don't mean money-wise, I mean like time afford. Because it's Thursday, I'm not allowed to like be on my phone on Saturday, and for half the day Friday I'm busy, but I need to upload every single week so the algorithm can expose me to stuff. Anyway, please read the description, and what do you think of my new OC? I did like show her before, but I didn't really make an announcement that this is my new main OC forever. That someone very special made me. Someone made me this. This isn't my design, though I did tweak up the design just a little bit to make it fit more of my style. But this isn't really my character design, it's someone else's character design. They made it for me, but I don't know if they want me to say their name, because they might be annoyed if you go to their channel, because I don't know. Alright, anyway, so please read the description. It's very, 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 very important that you read the description before asking any questions, because it's time consuming for me to respond. And this has got to be the shortest tutorial I've ever made, and possibly the crappiest. I'm sorry. Really. Have a good night, day, or wherever you are. Bye!